I'm a professor here at the Whitby campus of Durham College. I teach in the electrical construction and maintenance apprentice program. I'm also a graduate. In 2002, I did my advanced trade school here. So I'm going to take you in and show you the new phase two expansion. Let's have a look at my crib. So here we are inside. This is the new office area here. There's Belinda and Mary working hard every day, always saying hello and goodbye. This whole area has been altered and there's been office space and testing rooms put in there. A lot of our administrative support staff have been given their own offices, which is good. It's not so much compiled into a big lunchroom anymore. And the boardroom down there. So here we are in the new student gathering area, I guess you call it. It's sort of an extension of our cafeteria. And when I started here at Durham College, my desk was in exactly this spot. This is where it was. It wasn't the cafeteria then. It was a lot of tiny little offices for tiny little people, and we've got some new ones. I'm gonna take you upstairs and show those now. A lot of new classroom space. Since I've been here, which is 7 years now, we've really, it's not been a major issue, but times you'll get class space that's just simply not big enough. And I think Durham College has done well to address that. This is being called the chemistry lab at the moment. A lot of lab stations with wired in receptacles at the table. You can see the ductwork up there to get everything out of the classroom when you are working with toxic sort of chemicals and things like that that can be dangerous. Here's an eyewash station here, and it's even got a complete shower unit on there, sort of like the showers they had in MASH. Let's see what's going on. It's on, it works. And there's a floor drain right there, which is cool. And I'm thinking that this thing will probably shut itself off, and it does with a little help. Good thing I wasn't under it at the time. Refreshing nonetheless. Okay, so we'll make our way over to a part of the building that doesn't have any plumbing installed yet, thankfully. And I've isolated the two important keys that I need. I'm usually a fumbler with my keychain. And it's always the last one you check, it seems. Come on in and I'll show you the new office area. The natural lighting, a lot of windows. These guys won the arm wrestling contest for the window offices. It's nice daylight, keep people from getting too depressed. And we've got that awesome view of the 401. So we'll come down the middle hallway here to office 230, and that's me there. This is my system of filing here, as opposed to my partner Steve. Very neat. I would do well to mimic his example. And here's my desk. Some artwork from my kids and my little shrine to Buddha. We were told no fridges, no microwaves in the offices, but I think we're gonna move one in anyways. I've talked about natural lighting, talked about good cabinetry, nameplates and all that, but the prime, hello Richard, how are you? And Richard would agree, the prime jewel in this new office space is our own staff washroom. Where I'm gonna take you guys next, and aside from kidding aside about the crown jewel of the office space and everything, the real reason and the real function of this expansion has been the new shop space that's put in the classroom space. We've got sort of a sky view of that right down there, and I'm gonna take you downstairs and show you that now. This is the HVAC shop. No shower eyewash station in here, I'll watch out for that. What they'll be doing in this class, if you can have a look at the ductwork, sheet metal fabrication, electrical pipes and electrical panels. That's actually some very nice pipe work up there. Maybe I would have done a concentric bend around there, but anyway, very, very well equipped lab. We haven't taught carpentry here at Durham College for, I'm not sure, ever. I know we had a stonemason program at one point, but they're looking at getting the carpentry apprenticeship program. Although it's empty now, the equipment's going to be installed over the summer. And as far as equipment goes, you'd be looking at table saws, jigsaws, band saws, framing nailers, and things like that. All of the things with compressors that a carpenter would need to use. and another shower station over there, which I won't test out this time. Outside, we have Banting House, which is an older structure that was moved from a place elsewhere in Durham. There's also going to be a brand new house built with current methods that they'll also get to have accessible for a lab and to work on. We'll go into what is known as the energy shop. We'll study and learn and get to work with things like motor generator sets, solar photovoltaic panels, and any type of fuel cells and things like that. We have our Amitrol lab simulators, where we have all aspects of a residential or commercial refrigeration system. There's actually two coffee options. There's the Tim's option, where it always has at least 70 people in the lineup. And there's our own cafeteria over there, the option for people who are a little less patient. This is our Whitby campus library. Some might argue that this would only be official when we have books in it. There are the first two books in the Whitby library there. In this chapter, we will learn about another popular method of solving sets of equations known as the calculator. Just joking. So, there you go. A lot of our students are apprentices, and I remember when I was in the trade as an electrician, it was always hard to find a place where I could access the internet. Still an issue with apprentices, so it's good that we have this place for them. They can come access the internet, their marks and their class schedules and things like that. Well, thanks for joining me on our tour of Whitby Phase 2. Peace out. Whitby represent.